has been computed by us. It has nothing to do with age of the children. You understand?
Now, if you will sign this statement, it shows your income and your expenses, Mr. Marshall, and get it back to me within 2 weeks. You understand?
Yes, I understand all that. But listen, I got to ask you something because I got to think about this thing. What happens if I lose my job?
If you're married, you must apply for welfare.
Well, I must apply for welfare?
You must apply for welfare. Otherwise, this would constitute a misuse of ADC funds.
Which is fraud.
You understand? If the husband's unwilling or unable to make a contribution equal to what it would cost him to maintain an independent living arrangement, he must apply for welfare. Do you understand? Otherwise, this would constitute a misuse of ADC funds.
Which is fraud.
Which is misappropriation.
Which is fraud.
Right, okay, now wait. Wait a minute. Now, if I marry this lady, I want to make things better. But if I spend a dollar on it, you're going to deduct it from her, right? If I want to buy a little something extra, you're going to deduct it. And I better report every penny I spend, or else I'm a crook. Okay, now you say if I lose my job, I must apply for welfare because I can't just sit around eating the government's biscuit.
Which is fraud.
Scott, that's a fraud, right? Okay, now if I do go into welfare, then I'm just another lazy ass nigga living off taxpayer. All right, now, suppose I do not marry this lady. Now, if I move in with her and do not tell you, then we're both crooks, right? But if I do tell you, then we're back to the income and the outcome and the deducting, and you drive me to drink. And you call a fraud if I spend $7 for a bottle of whiskey. Come on, partner, let's get out. You can't win. Understand? Fraud.
Don't you hear me?
Children, and I'm meant to be unfit. I must divorce him, cut all my ties with the consequences that make me sick. It's a hard sacrifice.
Hard sacrifice.
That having me a dirty man. Society gave us no choice. Tried to silence my voice, pushing me on the welfare.
Stand there, let her in.
I'm trying to prove my equal
rights. Hello, Charles.
I made some mistakes, for goodness sakes. Why should he have this?
Hello there. I'm sorry, I didn't hear the door. Children, would you cut that music down? Just turn it down.
Hello, Mrs. Price.
Hi.
How have you been?
Oh, grand. Living like a queen.
Price, have you been working?
No.
Because if you have, I really have to know. Otherwise, you get into trouble.
No, I ain't been working.
Mrs. Price, you know I'm your friend, mm-hmm. but you have to be honest with me.
I ain't been working.
Well, I understand a man's been visiting you regularly this past month.
You are not supposed to spy on us.
I didn't spy on you, Mrs. Price, but someone has.
It must be that lady, that bitch across the street. She'll say anything, that bitch.
The thing is, Mrs. Price, if something comes out later and I don't know about it, you'll be in all kinds of trouble. So, if you've been seeing this man...
Well, what is this? Am I not supposed to see a man? What am I, a damn nun?
No, but if you've been sleeping with a man and he's been giving you things, I'm sorry, but I have to know.
Do you sleep with a man?
Now, that's none of your business.
It's none of your business either.
You're wrong, Mrs. Price. It is our business. This man may be bringing things into your home which you may not be deducting. Now, you know I have to deduct you on those things.
What things? What things, damn it? You have a man come over for dinner, he brings you a bottle of wine. I have a man come over for dinner, he brings me a damn six-pack. Oh, there are two left, Miss Kayback. Would you like a beer?
I'm sorry, Mrs. Price.
I'm sorry, too. I figured it out. It comes to about $1.35. If he brings my kids some soda, that's about 80 cents. Now, with quick figuring, that comes to about $2.15, Miss Kayback. That's plus tax.
You mean to tell me that's all he gives you? $2.15.
How much do you get?
I want to start off by giving all praises, glory, and honor. All right, to our Lord, our Savior, our power, whose name is, in the Hebrew tongue, Yahweh. That is Yahweh. That is the Most High's name, which interprets to means he is to be, he exists, he is in all things. Bahashem. Bahashem means in the name. And Yahawashai. Yahawashai is who the world ignorantly calls Jesus Christ. In the Hebrew tongue, his name is Yahawashai, which means he's a savior. He's a deliverer. All right? And he's a deliverer and a savior to his people, according to Matthew 1 and 21. All right? His people, so on possessive or ownership. All right? Not all. And his people would have to be the Hebrew Israelites, because it's evident that he sprang out of the tribe of Judah. All right, so all praises to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem Rakakudash, in the name of the Holy Spirit. I'm going to give double honors to the apostles of GMS. Those are our teachers who taught us this truth, who rule well. A special salutations to the Akim out there, elders out there, those who are laboring in this truth, the sisters supporting the ministry. I'm Yalak Mara'ah from the Shepherd of Berea Camp, and salutations to the fellow Akim of the Shepherd of Berea Camp. I just played a clip, two clips from the movie Claudine. Now, you're looking at an image of a rapper by the name of Lil Uzi Vert. Now, the essence of this lesson is just to show the assistance of the mixture of pretty much Esau Edom in the Bible is who you see now, which society know as the so-called white man, the government that's in power. All right, and how they prescribed and designed a system through the another power source, which Satan worked through the garden, which Lord willing we'll get into, which is the mother, Eve, in order to bring forth what? These degenerate seeds, all right? And which you see Lil Uzi Vert. And Lil Uzi Vert have made statements about bringing people into Satan. I could turn a city girl into a Satan worshiper. You know, he has a Baphomet symbol on his chest. And, you know, well known for his androgynous look, which is between feminine and masculine. You know, Prince would have that androgynous look. And that's kind of like a lot of the NBA players now. They're painting their nails black. You know, that's been the real spirit that has been being pushed. And that's a vibration through Satan. And really, the essence of this all, okay, these are the curses that we up under. But as the scriptures say, you help forward their affliction. And the you in reference to is being Esau, Edom, all right? Because they ain't no way possible, way, shape, or form, all right? By spiritual, mental, financial, did they help uplift the so-called blacks, Latinos, Native Americans, who are the Hebrew Israelites in any way, all right? And if you say the welfare, well, welfare came with a price. And this is the point, the essence of this lesson. I'm going to show one more image and I'm going to get a few scriptures. Right? So maybe if you ain't catch it, which is showing before the transition. Now, you know what transition, talking about a man, you know, transitioning his body to be as a female, all right? You know, I got a quick article as well. Tattooed obsessed mother is slammed for covering her one-year-old baby in fake body art as critics accuse her of being a bad mom who is raising her son to be a gangster and a thug. All right, so this is how she been doing with what she been doing with her son for years. All right, no way do you see a man around. Look at the way she dressed. Look at the way she has a son. And you know, those dreads, tattoo body art. You know, just the pure degenerate things. All right, and that's her getting tattooed up while being pregnant. All right, so the scriptures say, and I'm going to get this real quick. Let's go to you. Start off with Jeremiah. Start off with the book of Jeremiah. Jeremiah chapter 2, verse 21. We are the children of the Lord. That's why we are called Israelites. This is Jeremiah chapter 2, verse 21. It says, yet I have planted thee a noble vine. So in the beginning, how the Lord started us out, right, is as a noble vine, all right, us being holy by giving, by receiving his law, statutes, and commandments, all right? That's what made us noble, all right, that the Lord has sanctified us with his word, all right, and his promises, all right? So the noble vine, thee, is talking about Israel. Holy, a right seed. That's why also you might see it say Jezreel, which it means another way of seeing a righteous seed or upright one. It says, holy, a right seed. How then art thou turned into a degenerate plant of a strange vine unto me? See, these images that you see are degenerate because the scriptures are against locks. They're against tattoos. All right. Salakia. They're against locks. They're against tattoos. You know, showing the baby's chest is all out, you know, just pure nakedness. The woman, head uncovered, orange hair. So, you know, tattoos on her body. And how is the question? And that's what we're going to get into, man. All right. Yet I planted thee a noble vine, holy, a right seed. How then art thou turned into a degenerate plant of a strange vine unto me? It says, for though thou wash thee with nitre and take thee much soap, yet thy iniquity is marked before me, saith the Lord God. So this is the essence of why Yahweh Shai was so important, because that actually cleansed us. All right. It was no other way we could be clean but by the sacrifice that Yahweh Shai made. All right. The point is how then we turn into the degenerate plant? Well, as you know, you watch the clip. To get into that with Claudine, this was a major assistance of turning us into this degenerate, how we became this degenerate plant, because the woman would only receive assistance if the father was not inside the house. As you could see, he was kind of like playing what you could say, what people say, devil's advocate. We would call it angel's advocate, right? You know, because he questioned on him. So you saying, if I'm moving with her, right, you're going to take the money from her that I'm giving her anyway with the assistance with all of those kids. But if I end up losing my job, I can't just sit around. I got to come back on. I got to apply for the welfare myself. And you telling me that if I provide for her, she can't receive welfare. But if I lose my job, I got to apply for the welfare. And it's just this weird system. But the system, as you can see in the next clip, and there was one more, where the woman did see him in the house. And pretty much, you've seen in the clip where she asked her about was she receiving support, and she mentioned about the beers, and she said, well, I got to deduct that. Because if you had a man in the house, you know, you would pretty much be lose out on the support of the government. Not that the government was giving much for her to live with all those kids, but she would lose what she had. So in this society that we in, there's a lot of our people that a lot of the women that live in off of this you know, the system, that don't that aren't married or aren't with a man, or even will kick the man out and put them on the child support to receive more of that money. But with Breed, the point that I'm getting at is that is what breeds the little Uzi Verts, the androgynousness, which is on a very high level right now, man. You know, just want to it mentions that inside the Wikipedia, Simeon Bison Woods, known professionally as Little Uzi Vert, is an American rapper. Singer, writer. They are characterized by their facial tattoos. So you see the kid, facial piercings, eccentric hairstyles, and androgynous fashion. Right? Going to that word androgynous, is possession of both masculine and feminine characteristics. All right, so pretty much, you know, you know you in between both, which they would say bi or bisexual. So he's giving off a masculine, and you know, because he is a man, but then the feminine traits, the way he'll have his hair, the way he'll dance, the way he'll move, things of that nature. Those don't know, you know, this is the guy who everybody is doing that dance. I just want to rock, you know. And not to get too far off the topic, this is what is being brought forth. All right, so I want to bring out another scripture. This is why this society, all right, has to fall. What benefit has this society brought to us as a people? Think about it. What is the benefits that this society has brought to us as a people? We were brought here as slaves, right? We built this society up. Nobody repaired, nobody counted our labors, our work, because now they call us, you know, they say we lazy, we good for nothing, all right? We had to learn to read. I mean, you know, what has this society brought forth? The only thing spiritually that the society has brought forth is that it turned us back into our Lord, Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. That's the only thing that the society did, which was the most impactful thing, because this in the land of our captivity, we shall remember the Lord, which is the purpose of it, you know, when you really get down to it. But beyond that, to say, you know, we need the society, well, what did it bring forth? What did it bring forth? Well, we're looking at the fruits of it. Go outside, right? Look and hear the kids' conversations. Look at how most of the kids' hairstyles are. Most of them long dreads, right? Most of them are like their minds is just, you know, all mind warped and stuff like that. Not to say that, you know, when I was younger or I had any sense and stuff like that. It's only through the Holy Spirit that the Lord have us in His truth and operating that way. So it's not saying any credibility on our behalf or ourselves. But without that, what is this society bringing forth? Okay, who are the rappers that they constantly showing? All right, all these new Memphis rappers, Glorilla. What was she talking about? She eats her boyfriend's cum off of French fries. You know, Meg Thee Stallion, Cardi B, WAP videos. You know, wet ass pussy. You know, this is what's being set forth. The Instagram following, all right, the style of dressing, mischief boots, you know, painting the nails black, all right, this whole movement of sexual transitioning, all right? So, in a sense, all right, and not even in a sense, at the core of it, this is what helped, it says, bring forth that degenerate seed. It's taking a father out the house, but through this program, all right, during the welfare, all right, and black women's liberation, then working, all right, and being able to receive assistance, and not have to deal with a man, right? Micah 2:1, woe to them that devise iniquity and work evil upon their beds. This was a device. This is what is a device. All right, not all devices got to be something. Device, paperwork, programs, documentation. All right, this was a device. All right, when the morning is light, they practice it. when the morning is light, you know, during the day, they went out and practiced. They pushed it forth. Because it is in the power of their hand. And it was, and who is it coming from? Esau, Edom. And they covet fields and take them by violence and houses and take them away. So they oppress a man and his house, even a man and his heritage. Who's oppressing a man, a house, and his heritage? What's the heritage they're oppressing? The heritage of Jacob, all right? The house of David, all right? But it's going to, you know, it says the gates of hell shall not prevail, in which they aren't. But at the same time, when we see our people, you know, and it's bothersome and it's troubling, you know, it's a disappointment. But, you know, without the Holy Spirit, we will all be like that. Could look at this. Look at how the system is built. Look at what's being fed on the TV. Look at the TV shows. I mean, it's constant. You know, there's nowhere to turn from it, man. Being completely honest, there's nowhere to turn from it. It's very surprising through the Holy Spirit that, you know, we are in a state we are in. If brothers got children, they're somewhere. Might not be as best that you would want them to be, but they ain't fully consumed. You know, Lord willing, they don't be. But, this is a real big push out here, man. You know? Scripture I want to get is Isaiah 10 and 1. Isaiah chapter 10, verse 1. It says, woe unto them that decree unrighteous decrees and write grievousness which they have prescribed. So they didn't just write it. They thought about it. Once again, in Micah 2 and 1, they thought about it before. They written it. They thought about it. They devised it upon a bed. All right. And it's an unrighteous decree. You know, or if you got this individual here, OK, we're not going to take part. But then this has to be reported. Oh, you can only get this when this man's not in the house. What option you going to think when the devil come to the woman? Well, let's go back to Genesis in the garden and think about that. All right. Because they're going to it's designed for the man to think about it. But when they think about it, of course, they're not going to make the right decision. They wasn't set up to make the right decision. That's why we got put in this scenario in a garden. All right. This is Genesis chapter 3. Verse 1. Now, the serpent was more subtile than any beast of the field. We're dealing with a subtile serpent. So he's not coming up front and plain. He's coming with subtlety. Right. So the serpent is dealing with the characteristics of a man. All right. It says, which the beast of the field, which the Lord God had made. He said unto the woman, yea, have God said, ye shall not eat of every tree in the garden. And the woman said unto the serpent, we may eat of the fruit of the trees of the garden, but of the fruit of the tree, which is in the midst of the garden, God hath said, ye shall not eat of it, neither shall ye touch it, lest ye die. So he asked a question with the answer that he already knew. Because why would you ask that question specifically about trees of the garden? Why isn't it about anything else? All right. But he wanted to know a stance, right? And the serpent said unto woman, ye shall not surely die. Here we go. Verse 5, for God know that in the day ye eat thereof, then your eyes shall be opened, and ye shall be as gods, knowing good and evil. And when the woman saw that the tree was good for food and that it was pleasant to the eyes, all right, you know, leaning on her understanding, there's a way that seemeth right to a person, you know, it's pleasant to her eyes. She seemed fit. Well, you know what? This will be beneficial. And a tree to be desired to make one wise, you know, this is the wise way to go. You know, more benefits. I'll be able to do more for my family. I'll be able to do this. I'll be able to do that, you know. And it seems right to the eyes, right? She took of the fruit thereof and did eat, and gave also unto her husband with her, and he did eat. He listened to her. All right, cool. You know, and boom. Now we in the shit that we in now. You know, once again, prescribing wickedness, you know, and once again, the tool being used, as we've seen from the clip, that's one of the tools being used as the welfare. You know, the other tool being used is the woman work, you know, going out and working the jobs that men will work, you know, instead of, you know, staying at the position that it used to be, which being a housewife, you know, it made sense, you know, oh, nah, it makes sense for us to go work. Now, of course, in a society, the woman that you would have to work, you know, unless the Most High has your hand blessed on a certain level, but, you know, at the same time, we're not set up in that power. But at that certain time, when it was, it broke free through to get into the minds of the woman first, you know, because the woman, the woman was just there to serve the house, which made things, it was better for her at the same time, because the woman does get burnt out, you know what I'm saying, doing the things. And then as a man, you got to start assisting in the house duties and stuff like that, because she's at work. And then, you know, if you work and then you know, it's like, then you're complaining about who's taking them on the tolls. And this is the tribulation you're going to have, you know, in a society with dealing with a woman, dealing with a family, you know, because this whole setup. But once again, this was devised and set up, man, to bring forth what? Let's get it. Second Edris, chapter 5, verse 8. There shall be a confusion also in many places. Right now, man, this is the biggest confusion. People's mindsets, don't know what to identify a woman as no more. You know, it's a big confusion out here. You know, there's a big confusion in this land. And the fire shall be off, sent out. And the wild beasts shall change their places, right? You got, the wild, the animals are confused. The seasons is out of course. You have hail falling down in the spring. You got the weather just up and down. You got the beasts. Don't know, you know, they're out of location, all right? And it says, a minstrel's woman shall bring forth monsters. So what are you producing? These little Uzi Verts, these Sauce Walkers, or Saucy Santanas. All right? I mean, it's a whole list. Who's this guy who just got jumped in at LA Fitness? Tekashi 6ix9ine. That's a big character. But once again, all of these, and when you read about his story, it's the same thing. He's seen the man who was taking care of his mother, or he looked up to as a father, got shot and killed. I believe he said it was in front of him, you know, and that scarred him. You know what I'm saying? So this again, going into the device that this devil used, is really coming at the system of what holds up a household, and it's dealing with the father working and coinciding with the mother, all right, and being able to pretty much dealing with and Most High dealing with them both together to be able to bring forth, right, that noble seed, or bring forth that child where he will be wise and maneuver throughout the society. Now this society is so wicked that even being in the house with the mother and the father, the child could still come out, and that's due to this heavy influences of the other kids that's around that may not have a father, mother, or just the internet itself. All right, that's being produced with by another bastard child, and the ultimate bastard child, Esau, Edom. All right, but this is what's going on. Right, this is Sirach chapter. This is why we say this society has to fall, man. All right, this society got to fall, because what is it bringing for? What good is it producing? Think of this as a machine, right? Think of it as a factory, right? Or think of it as a filter, right? Now, you know, or AC or something like that. You know, something that's supposed to produce clean, cleanse your air and produce clean air. Now, that machine is shooting out toxic chemicals, right? And you're getting, you know, now you got, you have lung damage, right? Then you got throat cancer. You know what I mean? Then your wife develops it. Then your child develops it. What do you, and it's pointing to, well, this machine right here is what's causing that to you. Do you keep this machine in place, or do you throw that damn machine out, right? And then set it up with a one that's going to work correctly, Right. You're not going to keep that machine that's going to keep killing you and your family just because, oh, no, we had the machine here. This is all we know. Well, if cancer and death is all you know, well, let's try something else. You know, and that's what, you know, when we come out and we say that this society has to be destroyed, that's essentially through the Holy Spirit what we're saying. All right. And we're saying that this machine was set up to bring forth this toxic chemicals. And I'm talking about the machine is this system, Esau, Edom, this rulership, America, what's in society, Babylon the Great, what they're producing, the things that you see on TV, the music and everything, and all of this is totality, the religion, everything. You know, it was set up to show you what an evil society is so you can want a good and look forward to a good one. You know, this was just one of the tools that help with the pollution. There's many of them, but this was a major one right here. Dealing with removing the fathers out the house, right? And the mothers making the decisions. All right, this is Sirach chapter 3, verse 8. Honor thy father and mother, both in word and deed, that a blessing may come upon thee from them. So you're supposed to not just honor your mother. Most basketball players, most artists, most all damn near successful so-called African-Americans and Latinos and Native Americans, the first person they're honoring all the time is their mom. You know, not their dad because, oh, yeah, my dad wasn't around. He did this, he did that, whatever the case may be. Not knowing, once again, these whole systematic effects that took place, you know. Now, I know we just dealt with the welfare, but let's also think about the decision if the father's not around. Let's think about the father not working on the books so he can receive welfare. So what other jobs he's going to work off the books? Well, then you have the big drug empires that started being set up, all right, during those times. Dope being pushed, cocaine, then the whole crack era. You see, so there was always tools, and then they called it, what, a war on drugs. But where were these drugs being placed and located and found? They don't grow in the projects, but they somehow end up there. They somehow magically end up there. They grow all the way in Colombia, Afghanistan, the marijuana's growing somewhere in the woods up in Cali and shit like that. But they always end up somewhere in the so-called Black Latinos and Native American communities, right? And then there's a war on it, right? And then these are fathers being locked up, being killed, you know. And then these kids are growing up without them. And then the mother is receiving the assistance from there. All right. And then they're making ahead decisions. And this is what the degenerate stuff being pushed forth. The child's being raised nothing but by that estrogen, spirit and energy. All right. Emotions as well, you know, that would trouble any child, not having a dad around, wondering this, wondering that, why he left, why he's not here, I don't know, he doesn't like me, what was wrong with me, damn, oh man, I got fend for myself, let me just get crazy, you know, and things of that nature. So when we see how people, you know, it is disgust, it's a piss off, you know, but at the same time, you know, it's not even their fault. It was set up. Not to say that that's an excuse, because 2/3 of our people was going to be chopped and cut off, man. Because you can't have that poison lingering around. Imagine this. Where is this, man? Imagine this child right here, man, growing up. And I'm not saying that the Lord can't raise him up to come out of that. But I'm just saying, imagine him being at this stage. Well, how much worse do you think it's going to be? I got an image. A priest Tahawam has sent out, I don't know why I don't got it on his phone, but he had an image about a woman with how the image said, oh, man, I wish I could share it up on there. It said how this generation is going to look as grandmothers, you know. Because most of the females got fake butts. So what you think that fake butt going to do when they get older? It's going to sag down. It's going to be damn near on the floor dragging. They doing their lips. You know, so it's a big image with their lips all out. They breasts. They got that. They getting their breasts. They breasts done. That's going to fade away. So the grim. And then they got tattoos all over their bodies. So my thing is, that's what you said. How these images going to look as grandparents? Imagine this dude being a father, man. you know, at the rate I'm saying is being produced. I'm not saying they could the Kamosa could change and change the course, in which he did. But imagine him getting old. Imagine the influence he's going to have on other. He's going to school. Imagine the influence he's going to have around your sons and daughters. Okay? Imagine that. And then imagine how he, when with his kids, this is normal for him. So imagine how his kid, he might think it's cool to have a son and it, with the same way to chain on, might have a gang blood flight. Who knows, man? But it's just the mind. It will get. Point is that it's going, two thirds got to get cut off because of that. They are sick. All right, not their fault. It's got caught up, but due to that bad air and that bad machine, all of that shit got to get cleared out. Okay, you know. So, you know. And this is madness, man. It's very disgusting. But who you see? Who do you see? That's who's running it. That's who's running it. You know? That's who's running it, man. I have one more preset. A few more I just want to get. This is let me go back to Sirach. I ain't finished that. Sirach 3:9, for the blessing of the father establisheth the houses of the children. So the blessing will come to the father and that will establish the houses of children. So how you could tell that our house is being ran by the mothers, but the curse of the mother rooteth out foundations, because there's no foundation in his houses. One person believes in this. Another person believes in they could change their body into whatever. Another person believes that they're a damn nigger bot, a rapping machine. Another person believes that they're a damn weed smoking demon. Another person believes that they're, you know, the biggest goon. There's no foundation. One person believes they're blood. Another person believes they're a Crip. One person believes their name is Shitty Loke and they kill another dude. And it's just all types of madness. One person believes they're a crack dealer. He believes he's 5-0 set block. Another person thinks he's 6-00. One dude says OTF. There's no foundation. That's why it all falls. There's Nola Cartel, this El Chop. It all falls because there's no foundation. Why? Because the curse of the mother rooted out the foundation. This is how you're able to tell that our society is being ran by the woman. All right, there's no blessings. What area can you say, well, yes, these people were blessed? Well, you can look over in the Middle East and tell that the fathers is around, because them motherfuckers is blessed over there. You know, now it's set up that way. You know, but hey, their father, their culture, their foundations is around. You know how you could tell? Because the woman don't got a damn say so. They're covering up their faces. They're dressing a certain way. The man he's in power. He's ruling. You know, they're not giving their daughters to any old body. They don't accept every in each culture inside their around them. We do. You know, we can have the Chinese around us selling us. We'll believe we're Buddhists. We'll believe in their philosophies. We'll believe we're even Muslims and stuff like that. And even though they don't accept us inside of their culture fully to marry their woman or take over their businesses. So we accept a lot and okay and verify a lot of people to be around us and to take and everything, but not vice versa. You see, but that's, again, that's due to what? A mother. Well, a mother is going to have many different men inside the house. Since it's like a harlot, well, I accept him. Well, okay, nah, it's not bad. Because he do this. Yeah, I know he a drug dealer, but yeah, he bought me some Gucci shoes. Oh, yeah, nah, I know he blood, but, you know, he a real one. He, you know, he did this, he did that. You know, they're going to accept everything. It's no standard. Because who was the one supposed to teach her about the standard, give your daughter no passage, was the father. Nah, you don't accept. What image do she got to look at? You know, so that once again, that played a lot when you sit down and think about it. What image do she got to tell to compare to be like, well, you know, nah, I need a dude like this, I need a dude like that. And once again, just because there is a strong father in the house, you know, it would knock down a higher percentage. But that's not needless to say that that child won't go off or go astray. You know, hey, hence you got the one with the sons, the prodigal son. And, you know, that's just due to this world and the influences of Satan, you know, because they're friends that they're around, you know. But because I and my father used to be the same way, but then I went off and did the bullshit. But it preserved me a long way. I'll tell you that, you know, it preserved me a long way. You know, I ain't start bugging out until later on. But, you know, as ages, I grew rebellious and things of that nature, man. Trying to be, because once again, being around the friends, they didn't have fathers. They were fucking doing whatever they wanted. You know, they, you know, get at you, oh, I know your part, you know. So you try to essentially look down and not be, you know, trying to be like them instead of accepting the blessing that you had, you despise it. And now you get prolonged, you get set back in life. And these niggas, you know, they want you to get set back, you know? But that, you know, and it ain't even that fault, but they fault, because that's just they just don't know no better either. Anyway, let me just get back into the scriptures. This is I want to get Psalms chapter 94. Psalms chapter 94. Psalms chapter 94, verses 20. Says, shall the throne of iniquity have fellowship with thee? That's why this place got a fall. Shall this throne of iniquity, this is a throne of sin. Let's think about it, man. Think about it. How was this throne set up? Off of sin. How? How off of sin? Well, how did they get their land? They brought smallpox. They tricked the Native American Indians. They killed them. They oppressed their heritage. They put them in reservations. Who built it up? They grabbed Israelites over in western parts of Africa, all right? Sold them for oils and gold and all types of things, and it had them build up, you know, producing cotton, sugar cane, peppers, and things of that nature with free labor, all right? Also, we invented things that they got credit for their patents and built, you know. You got free labor. You got free labor around you. Why would you have to do anything if you got free labor around you, right? So are you going to do work if you got somebody to do it for you? No, you're going to be like, well, they're going to do it because that's how this shit was built up for rape, robbery, and murder. So the throne of iniquity, man, you know, a throne is a kingdom, man. So, how you know, that whole throne, your whole outline, your whole makeup, okay, was off of sin. You did not justly do one thing. Okay, so it says, have fellowship with thee. Has it said to have fellowship with us? You know, because, you know, going back to the same point, how could this thing stay? It's a throne of, how can it have fellowship with you? How, what good has it brought forth? It says, which frameth mischief by law. Think about that. Frames mischief by law. This is a mischievous device. Now, a frame is an outline. Okay. That outlines mischief all day, okay? Going back into, we was listening to it, Claudine, I'm watching, all right? Framing mischief through a term known as welfare. You know, framing mischief through a term known as equal opportunity. Framing mischief, you know, due to a term child support. You know, it's just fucking murals all over this fucking place, man. All right, in which it's framing to dethrone and keep destroying. All right, so it says, "Shall the throne that have fellowship with thee, which frameth mischief by law, and they do it by law." Think about it, man. Think about the law. That's part of the law. The welfare thing is part of the law. Child support is part of the law. Equal opportunity is part of the law. Women's liberation was a law. You know, the whole movement with these kids now, attacking the trend. They attacking kids, man, third graders. But talking about sex and making them aware, that's by law. This is mischief by law. Why? Because once they get them into that and they could able to bug out their minds and they could date your kids and take them out for booty dinners, you know, and pizza pies and shit and do all types of madness, you know, that's it. Who's going to come after that? Because you're going to, you know, you're gonna fade out and die, but then we got your kids. And now we able to, not only do we have them educated, you know, we're actually educating them completely about the way in the world, but then sexual education, and then they're having a relationship. They're going for the jugular, man. Verse 21, they gather themselves together against the soul of the righteous and condemn the innocent blood. And that's what's being done. That's why in Psalm 64, it says they set up snares and traps to say, who can see them? All right. Verse 22, but the Lord is my defense and my God is the rock of my refuge. And he shall bring upon them thine own iniquities, thy own iniquity. Yeah, that's why they got to come up with a damn opioid pretty much like they came over to pill that assists people's opioid overdose, okay, where they can buy over the counter because their kids is being affected by it. Now they want to stop abortions because their kid is being affected by it. You know? And, you know, and he shall bring upon them their own iniquity and shall cut them off of their in their own wickedness. Yea, the Lord our God shall cut them off. And they're going to be cut off, man. And the two-thirds with them that's fully indoctrinated in it. All right? I got one more preset. Two more, actually. I went and started off with this one. This is Matthew's, the book of Matthew's. The book of Matthew's chapter 12, verse 29. Matthew's chapter 12, verse 29. It says, or else, how can one enter into a strong man's house? Right? How can one enter into your house? How can one dictate and enter and who put my picture up on a wall? I want this house to eat these type of foods. I want this type of movies to be watched. I want these type of stories to be told at night. How can one enter into your house and spoil his goods? We read about Micah 2:1. He oppresses a man in a heritage, right? Spoil your goods, right? Except he bond a strong man first. Who's a strong man in the house? The father. Okay, so we get him out through the welfare program. We get him out through telling the woman that. Let her lead. Let her make the decision. Oh, and now she's struggling with the welfare, looking at welfare, looking at child support. Damn, this might be a better decision. Because he's not able to really, you know, like I could really control because, you know, not only did you step out before with another female, or you might be spending the money on the next female. So, you know. You know, let me just get all I can get. You know, and spoil his goods, except he buy the strong man first. Then he will spoil his house. Not the fact that the woman you save from this from the man who's pitching this idea to you. Not that you save from Satan, he gonna spoil you too. Now he got you believing in a whole nother God. Now he got you. Females become lesbians. Now they get into other females, and then more demons get on them. They don't get whatever satisfaction they thought they had. They don't get that because it God didn't set it up that way. And then they dealing with other men, and then you know before they know it, they're just a damn thought. And the children are seeing this, you know. The sons, the mothers, and they think this is the sons and the daughters, and they think that this is how relationships is. You know? So it bugs him that he's able to spoil the house because she's so preoccupied about maybe finding love and comfort, you know, except from the man who she was supposed to get it from. you know, and now like the kids, you know, no one's feeding into them. And then this devil is able to spoil them. It's only through the grace of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh that we that the Lord is raising up. And then he's dealing with his remnant, his elect, Lord willing, you know, doing this lesson. You know, Lord, the Holy Spirit is moving us to do these lessons and getting to us and showing us, Lord willing, we are, you know, stamped because every, you know, the Most High, you know, this is program. You know, he could choose. Hey, you know, it's his program. He could say, all right, I want you to be doing it. Then I, you know what? Not, you know, that's it. You know what I'm saying? So it's only once again, this is just giving credibility to Yahweh Bahashim Yahweh Shah. This is why we be thankful for, you know, because this is a heavy because it's how this became a degenerate plant, you know. This was a heavy chemical, a chemical X that was put in the system to turn this noble vine into a degenerate plant. I mean, you took him out a noble vine, bringing forth the best grapes, turn it to a motherfucking little shop of horror that eats blood and grow. I mean, that's pretty much what we came. Like, we grow off of blood and pain. You know, you don't grow unless you cut somebody, unless you got a quarter body, unless you beat on somebody, you know, play knockout. You ain't a real nigga if you ain't go to jail and, you know what I mean, and do these things. Like, that's Little Shop of Horror. That plant, you know, he grows off of blood and pain and eating people and devouring souls and shit. We came, that's pretty much. We're like the fucking Super Mario piranha plant that pops out the motherfucking thing. Just waiting to eat and devour, man. So what turn assisted with that was with this way, but him removing the father out the house and the ultimate father, okay? You know, the Lord. All right. Precept came to mind, man. I just slipped right by. Sheesh. Set. Dang. Let me get this one. Should have went with that one, but popped in mind. If it come back, I get it. But this the one, last one I have written down was Isaiah 3:11. Woe unto the wicked, it shall be well with him, for the reward of his hand shall be given him. As for my people, children are their oppressors, and women rule over them. O my people, they which lead thee cause thee to err, and destroy the way of thy paths. See? It says, that's it, man. So children are the oppressors. And when you when you look at the movie Clothing, he was like, damn, you know, I can't take care of all these children. You know, and we're dealing with finances. Women rule over the kids. Okay, children oppress the parents, if they oppress the streets. I mean, these are the ones who's pretty much bringing down the property value in your own neighborhood. That's why Charleston White has a platform. Imagine if children was their oppressors. Charleston White would have no platform. Vlad would have no platform. Think about all the platforms that set up. DJ Academics would have no platform. I mean, unless they would talk, the platform that they have, that they get big off of now, they wouldn't have. You know, think about all of that. You know, that all of the other YouTubers that just talk about all of the gang shit and all of that. What's that? Hood vlogs. You would have no platform unless they would be talking about Esau and his trailer park shit. You know, the lower, you know, the redneck squads. Anyway, it says, after my people, children are their oppressors, right? And women rule over them. Yeah, that's it, man. You seen the mother, man. Having tattoos all over her baby. She's ruling over that. She got a whole YouTube account and all that. He get millions of views and this and that and there. He's a star. Da, 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 da. That's how all of these parents think. So silly that these mothers start becoming, you see them on Instagram doing TikTok shit. They became the new children. They became the new children. It's like the children ruling over them. Got them doing the new TikTok stuff and, you know, just posting shit constantly in it. And this, you know, this is a dictated segment of what fun is. If you ain't doing these dances, you are a corny ass family. You know, like that's pretty much what they're saying. You know, because that is what this algorithm of Esau Edom have dictated. You know, this is your fun. Shake your ass on here. Do these feminine dances. All right. Do these little TikTok challenges. And that's it for you. And you notice what we big off of. We big off of the Ha Ha Davis. What's all these other guys, man? Like, we just big off of Folly. Tony, fucking this guy whose son died. You know, I mean, like, that's it. You know, I didn't mean to get too carried away. I wanted to be sure, but, you know, this is what you see, man. You know, anyway, it says Isaiah, that was it, man. That was the point, man. And it says, oh, my people, they which lead thee, cause thee to err. Who's leading? The woman is leading. All right? And if the woman ain't leading, it's a man. Then that man who grew up with the leading woman, who was led by the woman. You know? And, or the effeminate man. Who has a woman's spirit on him, right? They which lead thee cause thee to err, you know, and destroy the way of our paths. So yeah, we going somewhere. Oh no, but look how far we came. Oh no, you're right. We did. We went far. We went far behind. You two, we were like totally destroying and erasing the paths. That's how far we went. We went far as to removing the paths to a righteous way. I mean, we pretty much worked on closing off the way to the righteous. I mean, look at these rappers, man. You got this new guy established, G-E-S-T-G. I mean, Jay-Z's link up with these guys. You see him with them. So, oh, man, this is the guy to follow. That CME or CMG records, the whole Memphis with all of these new guys, these new characters, man. I mean, it's always a new nigga, man. Excuse my language. But, yeah, man, they destroyed the way of our paths, man. I mean, it's a damn shame. But that's it. That's it. That's all I want to say, man. There was another scripture I had in mind. It was fine. I totally forgot about it. Let me get this. Isaiah 3:4. And I will give children to be their princes, and babies shall rule over them. Yeah. A little baby. The baby. Young this person. Young that. Little this. Little that. It's just a bunch of fucking kids ruling this society. These niggas are still calling themselves little babies. The baby. Young G's. Young this. Young thug. Everybody's young child. A fucking group of children. The motherfucking little rascals is in control of the city. Damn shame. It's for real. And they are princes. Fucking... These are the princes. I'm the prince of the city. I got the keys. Keys of the city. And babies shall rule over them. And babes. That's it. And the people shall be oppressed. Everyone by another. And everyone by his neighbor. The child shall behave himself proudly against the ancient. And the base against the honorable. Fuck. Yeah. Yeah. So that's how far it went. You know? That's how far that motherfucking wealth, that whole system, that juice, have went. There you go. Habakkuk 2:1. I just ended off with that. So that's what you see, man. The child behaving himself proudly against the ancient. You know, they cutting on the ancient's ass. They make jokes on the ancient. You ain't in style. Yo, what are those? What are those? You know, because you don't know what the fuck going on. They don't know about them big-ass mischief boots. So, you know, they coming at you now. You, oh, what are those? Yo, what you, yo, man, look at this. Yo, look at this here. Yo, look at this. Look at that. You know, cutting and cracking on you and shit. You know. Habakkuk 2 and 15. Woe unto him that giveth his neighbor drink, that putteth thy bottle to him. Right, so you put the bottle to us, man. You gave us a drink. That motherfucking the drink you gave the woman, that whole play in the garden that you redid again with the woman's liberation, welfare, and all of that shit. That was a bottle of some Hindu. That was a bottle of devil E&J Devil Springs, man. You put it to the mouth and said, this was good. Yo, this is going to get you right. I'm telling you, you know. And maketh him drunken also that thou mayest look on their neck. And you made us drunken. And you look, you know, pointed the finger. Look at them, man. Look at them. They got no, they just got no family structure. Look at them. The woman, it's all out of, look how she, oh, man, no order. Oh, it's disgusting. Oh, my gosh. Look at all these kids. They got no dad in the house. Oh, man, they live off of welfare. They don't work. Look at the welfare recipients. Oh, they're just eating off of society, eating off of government taxes. Ugh. Thou art filled with shame for glory. Drink thou also. Let thy foreskin be uncovered. The cup of the Lord's right hand shall be turned unto thee, and shameful spewing shall be on thy glory. Yeah, motherfucker. It's going to be fall on you now. Nigga, you thought you was slick. You thought you was, the joke was always going. We was going to be the one. When you bored, you could just always be like, you know what, man? When shit's going wrong for you, Esau, you just thought you could just, you know, take a drive through the hood. You know what I'm saying? You got that one dude who always fucking driving through these fucked up neighborhoods and shit. You know, and he just documented. I don't know who the fuck he is, but that nigga got mad time on his hand because it got to be an Edomite. He just go through hoods and document that shit. You know, when you got time on your hand and you feeling down, you know, whatever the fuck's going on because some of your rules and your laws backfired on you smaller Edomites. And you just go look at Jake and just, you know, get off on that shit. Like, oh, yeah, look at this. Look how drunk they are off. Sheesh. Oh, my gosh. Who could live in that? Oh, man. Wow. Whoa. Man, I don't know. Wow, man. I'm just thankful. Look at me. Look. You know what I mean? My life is not as near as bad as that. You know, so you can feel better about yourself and shit. No. It's going to fall on you. You getting a pre, you know, we did a video on that. You getting a preview of your fucking future, man. All right? That's it, man. That's all I want. Let me read verse 17. For the violence of Lebanon shall cover thee and spoil you of the beast, which made them afraid because of men's blood. Yeah. And for the violence of the land and of the city of all that dwell therein. That's it, man. You know, once again, this video just going into showing the importance of the father being in that house, and then just as well as showing what the system that they use, these tools or these devices that they use, what it brought forth. You know, I use very few images, but because it's very vast. Just go look outside, man. Whenever you see something that ticks you off, just know that that was brought forth through that. You know, the mindset, the conversations, the dress code, you know. I mean, I look at them, you know, like this is what it brought forth, man. You know, real talk, man. Like, you know, LeBron and all of his glitz and glory, you know what I mean, who gives so much credibility to his mom and all of this, you know, such and such. He's broke this record, King James, number one. And stuff like that. At the end of the day, you know, besides him trying to cover up his hairline, you know, we've just seen a video of how he has his kids. His kids was shaking their ass in front of white men. Why would they do that? Well, what better would he know? Because all he did was perform for white men. That was success for him. He got all he got from performing in front of white men. So this is success. This is how you win. You know, why would I try to start another league? I'm leading the score. I got all these resources. Why? All I know is that, and that is the welfare. I depend on this man. I depend on him. He holds the house down. I must follow his rules. I must follow his regulations. That's what welfare is. It's a rule and a regulation you must follow to receive of his benefits.
and it's still there. They can't break away from it. It was raised off of it. They are plugged into that system, you know, and that's all they know. You know, throughout all the glory, you really think about it, in the empire, this is what wins. But what was he raised by? He's raised by that mom. I don't ever really see or even hear about LeBron James' father. A sit down or nothing. Not to say that we got to know it's personal, but I'm just saying, you know, that would, for him, he should know to do something like that. Even if he feel like, well, you know, I do things or whatever the case may be, it would be very impactful, because knowing that, that's a big impact on the so-called Blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans. Not mending relationships with fathers, you know, constantly holding grudges. And, you know, meanwhile, they went through all of this hell. Like, Esau is the one to blame. We take responsibility, too, because we have to take responsibility, too, because we went through with the action. But this nigga put the bottle. He made the concoction and put it through. He made the shit look right. Don't think this devil, he's a deceiver. He dressed this shit up. It looked like a good idea. You know, you put your hand to it and we got fucked up, man. We got fucked up. And here we are in 2023 realizing that, oh, shit. Oh man. You know, it was like Hangover 3. We just waking up off this shit, being drunk and like, oh shit, man. Yo, what happened? You know, they can't remember shit. And then we remember, oh yo, it was that bottle. That nigga gave us that shit. Oh shit, man. We can't fuck with that dude. You know what I'm saying? And we trying to tell others, but they still drunk. Some of them still knocked out. You know, you can't even be mad. They, everybody drunk from that, man. That Babylon, that's why I say she had a golden cup in her hand, man. You know? She had a golden cup. Another one, Habakkuk 2 and 5. Yay, also because he transgresseth by wine. So if he gave us in verse 15, he put the bottle to you, he transgresseth by wine. That was it. His philosophies, his drink, his concoction. He is a proud man, neither keepeth at home. His enlarged desire is hell, and is as death, cannot be satisfied, but gather unto him all nations and heapeth unto him all people. So this is what he's constantly doing. Okay. All right. Revelation 17, you know, goes into it as well. Revelation 7, the 17th chapter, speaking on Babylon, you know, is verse 2, says, with whom, so for one, and there came unto me seven angels, which had seven vials, and talked with me, saying unto me, come hither, I will show unto thee the judgment of the great whore. All right, this woman that sitteth upon many waters, the waters is the people, the whore is America. All right, the whore, whoredom, because the whore will abide with that person for the time being of that contract, that money. Okay, and then she's going to abide with that man for that time being with that money. And that's what America does. Going to do a deal with this person, Saudi Arabia, for this time. Going to deal with South Korea. This, but, you know, just open their legs up to anybody, right? And it says, with whom the kings of the earth have committed fornication. All right, they fornicated. Dealing with this, coming into these contracts, all right? And the inhabitants of the earth have been made drunk with the wine of her fornication. See? Verse 3. So he carried me away in the spirit into the wilderness. I saw a woman sit upon a scarlet colored beast, the NATO, the beast system. All right. Full of names of blasphemy, having seven heads, 10 horns, the EU. All right. And it says, and the woman was arrayed in purple and scarlet colored, decked with gold and precious stones and pearls, having a golden cup in her hand full of abominations and filthiness of her fornication. So that's what's in that cup, man. It's abominations. But it's a gold cup. So it ain't like he ain't dressed it up, right? It's just, we thought, damn, if that's a gold cup, then anything in there got to be good. And we drunk it away, and we coming to find out, we became filthy, abominable. And that's what I was just showing, you know, all these images.